Good morning, Facebook. This is Cars and Coffee Dave, and I'm coming at you live from 633 Fraser Drive in Franklin, Tennessee. Welcome to Nashville Cars and Coffee. You are on the AAA live stream. And today, we've got some cool stuff happening. That Hennessey Velociraptor that we just saw is a little teaser for what we got going later on. But it's a great day today. It's a beautiful day. It's a warm day. And if you live in the Middle Tennessee area within an hour of downtown Nashville, it is not too late for you to come out and enjoy the fun, because there is a lot of fun to be had. And look at these Porsches that we're driving by right here. All right. So we're going to be in a traffic jam. I want to swing by Supercar Row. So we're going to go around these guys basically and then swing up to the tent. Yeah, once we have some space here. So for everyone watching at home, I hope you're having a good weekend. Everything's getting off to a good start. You had a good Friday night. I know I had a good Friday night. I had the privilege of seeing Mr. Jason Mewes at Zaniac's last night, down there at Zany's? Oh, Zany's, not Zaniac's. It was Zany's Nashville, the comedy club. Let's see, Snoochies to Jason Mewes. And that was an awesome show. He was really entertaining, shared some great stories. No, go down one more. So yeah, for those of you wondering who I'm talking to, today I have a wonderful, talented chauffeur by the name of Megan Barker. I would highly recommend going to check out her website, meganbarker.com, if you are a fan of live music, if you like country music, pop country.
Or if you need a golf cart driver.
Or if you need a golf cart driver, yeah, she does that. Any other special talents? So there's a ton of cars out. I don't know if you guys have been paying attention on social media, but there were over 2,500 event responses to the event, and we're doing a quick drive by Brian's Motorsports. What up, Brian? Brian does a lot of off-road stuff. His custom Continental was back there, and we're gonna go take a look at that here in a minute when we go back on foot. But I just wanted to get to Supercar Row. We're gonna go up and around. So straight. So there's a Ferrari backing in. There's an M4. Slow down here a little bit. And okay, so yeah, we've got an Aventador. We've got a Urus right here. Stop for a second. So there's the first Urus that we've had here at the event. And pull up there to the right. I'm gonna get this. Stop it here. All right, guys, so we got a GT40 over there. There's a couple McLarens. The Fairlady Z06, that's a favorite that we've seen multiple times. Hey, guys, there's Josh Vaughn, one of our photographers, Danny from Freeland Chevrolet, some good vendors here that we know and talk to on a regular basis. We got an R8, and then again, here's this Urus. That's just, look at that angle from the front. I love that. And then you can obviously see the camera and sensors, other radar-y type equipment. And we are working with some tight quarters here. Unfortunately, and then look at that. That is really nice. Actually, if you stand right here, there's niceness everywhere. Look at that. Back of that Fairlady Z06. So guys, just to recap, it's April. It's going to be a great day today. The weather is excellent. John Hennessey is here with Brown Lead Ford. That Velociraptor I teased, that's a 6x6, not a 4x4, not a 4x2, not 4s and 2s, but a 6x6. So if you guys, again, if you're in the area and you want to come
check out some unique automobiles, some unique off-road creations, highly, highly encourage you to head on down to 633 Fraser Drive. It's just a short distance south of Nashville, and you too can join the fun.
All right, let's roll out. These people will yield to you. They're not going to hit you. Right. And so it's just going to be one traffic jam after the other. I mentioned it a second ago, but we had 2,500 event responses to this event today on Facebook, which is a lot. It's definitely our highest by a few hundred, by several hundred actually. And speaking of that, go straight on down. Okay, so we're gonna keep going straight until you see a flag, because that's where we're going. So like I was saying, so the idea with the chauffeur was that I can't talk and navigate and be a cameraman and try and produce, not very well, but try and produce at the same time and drive. It's kind of a safety issue. There's only so much Dave to go around, and let's be honest, gotta have the camera work come first. Now, Frame Center is a dump truck, and that's interesting for a couple of reasons. We've had a lot of interesting vehicles here, but a dump truck is one of those things that kind of makes you scratch your head and ask why. But you know what? When you think about it, it makes a lot of power out of that turbo diesel engine. And yeah, we like everything powerful. Doesn't matter what it looks like. So as I was saying moments ago, share this video with your friends. Let's keep the brand growing. Let's keep the experience growing. And tell all of your friends about Nashville Cars and Coffee. As you can see, the word is out. But it's amazing because, okay, see where it says Music City Camaro Club? That's where we're going. Because as you can see, every week I talk to more people, and they haven't heard of Nashville Cars and Coffee. And then you come out here and you see all of these people.
And I was
here, slow down a little bit. Slow down.
All right, so we are out here, and I'm gonna hop off real quick. All right, so wanted to come say hello to a couple local car clubs. We've got the Subaru Club right here, which is very hard to miss because you've got Subaru Blue everywhere. And let's hear that. Yeah, they're on this side too. So it looks like they color-coded themselves. If you guys drive a Subaru, like a Subaru, give me a like, give me a share. Over here on the other side, we've got Music City Camaro Club. Now, Tiger Shark, I know this guy. I talk about him, it seems like, every live stream, but the reason I do is because his car is that unique. It's just really eye-catching. It's, it's the, not Hennessey, it's Calgary. This is a Callaway, Calgary. Calgary is a place in Canada, Dave. This is a Callaway modified Camaro, and this guy comes to all sorts of automotive events in Middle Tennessee. If you're a Camaro fan, give this guy a like, give him a share. Check out that blower. Just so shiny, so clean. And he drives his car everywhere, so he takes really good care of it. Okay, so yeah, we've got more Camaros. Here's another sick Camaro. I don't know if I've ever seen this one before, but it's got signage. Let's check it out. 2014 RS. Looks like we've got a couple mods on here. The nice attention to detail here. Talk about going the extra mile. Color changing angel eyes right there in the middle. We've got a bunch of paint matched accessories under the hood. Got some signatures on the strut tower. Be interesting to learn more about that. All right, so thank you to all of our car clubs. Thank you to Music City Camaros. Thank you to the Subaru Club. Thank you to Music City Miatas, the Mustang Club, British Car Club. I mean, let's be honest, we've got a lot of car clubs in town. You guys all do a great job of representing out here, and most important, driving in a safe and courteous manner, which we all really appreciate. All right, guys, so now we get to just meander, right? No. We've got plans. We're schemers, as the Joker said. All right, so I feel like I'm talking to Siri.
I talk back more.
Wow, look at that. So that truck is way high off the ground. You could camp under that. All right, let's hang a right. No, go. You have to. And then go to the right of this guy. Okay. All right. Well, we've been traffic jammed.
Right?
No. Keep going straight. Oh, but you know what? That doesn't mean we can't capture cool content. Look at that Corvette. Nice noise. Oh, and a lot of motorcycles in attendance today. That's kind of a new development. Probably because today is the first day with above 60 degree temperatures. I mean, we've actually had a really mild winter, and we've gotten lucky out here. Turn right down at Nashville Power Sports. And so many. I'm starting to realize that I'm gonna have to just go off on foot here for a little bit.
This is my first rodeo.
Oh, it's okay.
There's too many people.
No, that's what it is. There's just too many people walking around. I mean, there are.
I think I can squeeze by easily.
There are hundreds or thousands of people walking around down here. Ron Pitts, when and where? The when is the first Saturday of every month. The where is 633 Fraser Drive. That's the AMC 20 Movie Theater, Franklin, Tennessee. We're just about 15, 20 minutes south of downtown Nashville. And then, yeah, turn right here. All right, so we got our friends from Nashville Power Sports here. They're actually the ones that allow us to use this golf cart to get around the event quicker. Big shout out to those guys. NashvillePowerSports.com is their website. And then we're stuck behind a Bentley, which I can think of worse places to be stuck in life than behind a Bentley. To be stuck under a Bentley, and that would definitely be a problem. We've got some more Porsches. All right, guys, we're gonna take a quick look at this McLaren. Yeah, Stephanie, Music City Miata Club is definitely here today. take a look inside there. Hanging out here. Have a feeling if you counted, you would see a lot of everything today. Lots of supercars early this morning. Unlimited number of modified street cars.
All right, let's try to get to the other side. Yeah, right, that side. Let's see here. All right, so Stephanie, Music City Modded Club, Jason, watching from Australia, will be in Nashville in June. Bridget Judah Franklin, yeah, so we're at 633 Fraser Drive, the AMC 20 movie theater. And, okay. I'm gonna meet you over there. So sometimes in life, the shortest distance between two points is a straight line. And, that's what I just did. Yeah, thanks, Angela. Yeah, the golf cart usually makes the event much, much easier to cover in an efficient manner, but today there's just too many people, there's too many cars. So, let's see here. Let's take a look at this Hennessey. Alright, so this is from our friends down at Brownlee Ford, south of Nashville. This is a Ford Velociraptor. Now, if you guys like what you're seeing here, hit the share button. Tell your friends, give us some likes. You know, we just crossed 20,000 on the NCC Facebook page. So you guys should be excited about that, because that's all you. That's all you. Look at that suspension. Now, in preparing for today, I did what I usually do. A little bit of research and stuff, but seeing this vehicle online and seeing it in person are two totally different things, because it is just so much bigger in person. And especially this section right here, that right there, it doesn't look as big when you see pictures online, but in person, it's massive. I mean, you could almost fit like a whole Mark 1 Mini in there.
What's going on, guys?
How you doing, Brock? From Brownlee Ford.
Hey, guys. Fantastic. We've got Hennessey Performance out here today. Alec Wyman, Director of Sales, and John Hennessey himself. We've got the 6x6, first ever Ford Performance Blue Hennessey Performance Velociraptor 6x6, and we've got a Ruby Red Standard Velociraptor. John's right here signing autographs.
Awesome.
And come out and check us out.
Can we grab him for a second?
Yeah, absolutely. We'll get John to come over.
Yeah, for sure. So we're going to hang out for a second, guys, until Mr. Hennessey becomes available. But this is the vehicle in question. And like I was saying, it's just absolutely massive. Absolutely. Very blue, too. I mean, this is one of those colors that you kind of want to taste, if you could. So I'm gonna take a look at the standard, the lesser 4x4, with only four wheels instead of six wheels. Hello. Hello, how are you?
Good, how are you doing?
My name's Cars and Coffee Dave.
Awesome.
Thank you for coming out today.
Glad to be here.
Absolutely, I'm glad that you're here too. So, you're very famous in the automotive world. You've been making fast cars faster for a long time.
Sure.
And, you know, can you tell the people at home what originally got you into cars?
Hey, Nashville Cars and Coffee, it's awesome to be here. What got me into cars? I guess my dad was a car guy growing up. I grew up in Kansas City, and I mean, before I can even remember, I'm told that, you know, my dad's out going fast, and I'm kind of cheering him on, so I guess that was kind of built into my DNA from an early age. And when I got into my, I guess I was in junior high, and this is before cell phones, obviously, and I was hanging out with my buddies, and I was supposed to be home. I knew I was supposed to be home, and my dad had to, like, go driving to the neighborhood to find me. He had a 68 GTO, and when he found me, he was pissed, and he looks over to me. I'm hanging out with my buddies and says, "You're supposed to be home, get your ass in the car." And I got in the car, and he took off, and he did this nasty burnout in the neighborhood. And when I got to school the next day, all my friends thought I was cool. And my dad did this burnout. I'm like, well, fast cars and burnouts, I'm like, and making friends, I'm like, well, that's kind of cool. And
hey, there's a recipe there.
So anyway, there's a recipe there, and a few years later, when I got into high school, I bought my first car, which was a 69 Olds 442 convertible, which I started modifying the day that I got it, and that's kind of all where it started. And then when I was in my 20s, bought a car, Mitsubishi 3000 GT, modified it, raced at the Pikes Peak and at Bonneville. And I learned the first rule of racing: if you want to make a small fortune racing, you start with a larger fortune. And when I'm doing these races and I'm watching my bank account kind of slowly going downwards, I thought, you know, I really enjoy the whole racing thing, but if I'm going to continue to do it, I got to figure out a way to get it to pay for itself. And I thought, well, you know, guys like Carroll Shelby and Alois Roof, Gail Banks, they made livings by modifying cars for other people. I thought, well, maybe I could do the same thing. And that was almost 29 years ago. So here we are.
And when you do what you love every day, it's not work.
Yeah, that's true.
So tell us about this 6x6 Velociraptor.
So our 6x6 Velociraptor, this is a special vehicle that we built for our special dealer here in the Nashville area, Brownlee Ford. And this is, this is maybe the 11th or 12th 6x6 that we built. So it's obviously very unique, six-wheel drive, 600 horsepower. The price tag on this beauty is about $380,000. And we just built and delivered one for a pretty famous musician, a guy named Post Malone.
Okay.
There's a video on YouTube of him taking delivery. I think it's got 8 million views or something.
Wow.
And so this is the first one, the only one that we built with the blue with the white stripes. It's kind of the classic Ford Mustang muscle car look. And so we're very proud to show this off here at Nashville Cars and Coffee.
Well, we're absolutely honored to have it. Truly a state-of-the-art off-road automotive vehicle. And I want to thank you very much for your time today. And thank you for making it and coming out.
Thanks to all the folks in Nashville for being so friendly. And love coming to Nashville. Great people, great food, great fun, a lot of great music. And I'll be back.
Absolutely. It's a pleasure, Mr. Hennessey.
Thank you, guys.
Thank you.
Have fun. See you. Bye.
Hey. All right, guys. So, hey, that was awesome. I just got to talk to John Hennessey about an awesome car he built. So check that one off the bucket list. And what's next? What is next? Okay, I need to find my golf cart. My transportation. I had to abandon. And I think we will go back to the golf cart. Oh, I found it. It was behind me. Alright, so that's interesting. John said he was from Kansas City. I did not know that.
Oh yeah, no, I didn't see that. Oh my god, no, I got
another guy. Need a ride?
Alright, let's head down to the dyno. See what's over in Dino Land. So we've still got some time here. Alright.
What?
Lots of dogs out today. People bringing their four-legged companions out.
It's a dog show.
There's one right there. So that's three dogs in the last few minutes. So we want to go to the back right corner. You can turn right here. Alright guys, that's me trying to cover the mic. frustrated by the traffic, but it's not happening. Look at this Jeep. Yeah, if you're using headphones there, I apologize. That was a very large, very loud exhaust with a decent sized camshaft. Got some old square body trucks. If you like square body trucks, give me a like. Look at that. I wonder if these guys got like a square body club. Oh, this thing. I saw this thing come up behind me as I was turning in. Look at those, look at that back. Dually, right? But like a wide, wide dually. TRSCCA, Tennessee Regional Sports Car Club of America. TRSCCA.org. Highly recommend if you guys want to get involved into local autocross. Check these guys out. If you're in Middle Tennessee, TRSCCA.org. If you live in parts of the planet other than Middle Tennessee, I'm sure there's autocross in your area, other sports car organizations, where you can enjoy your passion for motorsports in a safe and responsible way. Highly recommend we do that. Oh, we've got two food trucks here today? Okay. Did not know that, but that's good to know. What do we got? What do we got? This is some sort of infinity goodness, it looks like. I don't know. Our friends from Muletown Mobile Dino are in there. Keith is working his magic, doing the tying down of the car. Okay, so no, I was wrong on that. Tommy Whalen would have loved to have been there with my Z06 bet. Well, Tommy, we would love to have you here with your Z06 bet. Or Saline Mustang. Yeah, hey, either one of those works for me. So, hey, Keith.
How's it going?
This is Keith with Muletown Mobile Dyno. Keith is going to automotive events all over Middle Tennessee on a regular basis. Not just Middle Tennessee, but well beyond. He's all over the South.
Daytona next Saturday.
Daytona
Speedway.
Awesome. And you have a website, right?
MuletownDyno.com.
MuletownDyno.com. Go check this guy out. He does great work. He built this entire rig that we're standing in with this mobile dyno right here. And we have soon to be another satisfied customer getting ready to dyno his car. So it looks like it's going to take a few more minutes for him to be ready to spool it up. So we're not going to stick around for that. But we will continue looking at what's here at Nashville Cars and Coffee. So why don't we go that way?
Sorry. Sorry, thank you guys.
Hey.
Hey.
Hey. I think he had more to say. And then he saw us on camera. Ooh, ready 30, I like. Yeah. To the right. There's a dude. Hold on. There's a dude with a parrot on his shoulder.
Oh my gosh.
Is that Cars and Coffee Dave?
It is Cars and Coffee Dave. Hey, how are you guys?
Good. How you doing?
Thanks for coming out.
Always. Great day.
Yeah, swing around these guys.
Do it.
So you're like a mouse and they're like a bunch of big dogs with no traction on wood floors.
Go right or left?
Go left. Actually, no, go right. Go right. Go right. Okay, so guys, if you're a longtime viewer of this, you know I've been talking about the secret car meet for forever. Okay, well, this is one of the benefits of being on four wheels here, is we get to go look at the secret meet. So shoot through there. He's gonna stop. He's gonna stop. Okay, we got a lightning here. Oh no.
Now we are stuck.
No, not another traffic jam. I mean, this, let's be honest, this guy's got room. He's got room. All right, so We're just gonna keep doing this.
Crazy.
It is crazy. Still looking for a spot?
No.
No? Thanks for coming by. Yeah, he's got that right. It is crazy. So even here behind the movie theater, you got that Z4. Got a Ford ST up here. Thank you for watching the live stream. Ivan Cordova, any RX-7s? Most likely. If I was an 8-ball, I would say the outlook is good. Check out this Corvette. I hear something going on with this Corvette. Right? There's the car behind him. Yeah, no, it's this one. Okay, so my idea backfired on me. I kind of thought there was going to be more cars back there, but I think my point has been made. So we've got a 370 Nismo right here. So that's, you know, just sitting back here. You never know what you're going to find back here behind it or on the wings on the side of Cars and Coffee. Blue Camaro, blue Mustang. Little hood chop action. Sometimes you just need to make a little room. All right, so hopefully my oh, and then we got Franklin PD just hanging out back here doing their thing. All right, so my transportation will catch up to me momentarily, but what is that I see in the distance? I think this kind of gets to my point again. So there's just so many people here. There's so many cars. You know, all of the hypercars, old supercars, old high performance cars, even the new ones. Got to find some place to park. Hey man.
What's up, man?
Having trouble, hard time finding a parking spot?
I'm gonna sit here and watch the cars go by. There's no place to park.
Well, you could post up anywhere and see everything eventually.
Yeah.
How long you had this?
I got it last July.
Last July.
Yeah, yeah.
That's how many miles you put on it?
Not too much, about 1,000.
Yeah?
That's my first show out here. I need to come a little earlier.
Yeah, okay, so I mean people really do get here at about 6:30, 7 o'clock sometimes. And we had over 2,500 event responses on Facebook, so it's been a you know, guess kind of a long winter, so everyone's ready to get out.
Yeah, it's definitely. I was gonna come last month, but it's a little overcast. Do you have a YouTube channel?
Yes, we do. Nashville Cars and Coffee on YouTube, Nashville Cars and Coffee on Facebook and Instagram.
I watched your YouTube post yesterday to see what it's gonna be like, and I had no idea it's gonna be like this.
It's a good turnout today. It's a good turnout
for
today.
Sure. If I can find a park. Place the park, I can walk around a little more.
Now, are you local Nashville, or did you drive in from somewhere?
Bellevue.
Okay, cool. All right, well, as long as you didn't come up from Atlanta or Charlotte or something like that, you know?
I'll be back next month, a little earlier, though.
Yeah, for sure, man. If you swing by the tent up at the front and you find one of these hat on and ask them if there's any spots up there that you see, they'll probably let you in. So,
okay, cool.
Yeah.
Thanks, man.
You're welcome. Thanks for coming out. Have a great day.
Thanks, you too.
All right, so my golf cart is still not with me. That's interesting. I'm like lost. Okay, but we're gonna keep on trucking, guys. Yeah, we're definitely at capacity now. Definitely at capacity here. Got a couple E90 M3s sitting next to each other. And what is this? Okay. I gotta take a picture of this on my personal phone just cause. I had a Mercury Marauder when I was growing up, and it's interesting to see what has happened here. Cause we seem to be missing a hood. That's the first thing that I notice. The rest of it is pretty familiar. 4.6, 32 valve. Looks like we got some nitrous running around there. Looks like we paint matched some stuff. And man, the Marauder is such a cool car. Too bad they didn't supercharge it from the factory like they coulda. Woulda, coulda, shoulda. Throw that Eaton on there, make 400, 400. Be a totally different car. What time is it? 9:15. So guys, it's not too late. We go till 10:30, and I think we'll be going to every bit of 10:30 today, and then some. I know there's a lot of people that just hang out until well after. A lot of people go to AMC 20 afterwards and catch a movie. Awesome, perfect timing. It took you that long to get through.
Hey, loser.
Hey, how are you?
Good. You respond back. I was like, yeah, my car's only fucking over there. It's like, it's getting here at 8:30.
So,
first time, I didn't know.
We're about to head over to Music City Miatas right now. And they asked to jump on the live stream. So we're going to head that direction right now.
Where are you going? Left.
You can go straight and then left. Ooh, an international scout. The internationals are hanging out over here. I like. I've seen those guys before. Yeah, I mean, that is an excellent question. I mean, that would be ideal in an ideal world, but, you know, not sure how feasible that is. Alright, so we are coming up on Music City Miatas. These guys, probably one of our strongest showing car clubs. They regularly, I think their highest is 35. I think 35 was the most I ever counted from them. Oh, so can you go around this? This guy's backing in. So here we are with Music City Miatas on our right. Oh, there's a Le Mans. Oh, right there, Music City Miata. Come and join the fun. So you will see MX-5 from every generation here. And what up? These guys are great supporters of Nashville Cars and Coffee. I'm right here, right now. So these guys are, I love what they do. And check out Music City Miatas, Music City Miata Club.
Hi,
how are you?
So thankful you came by.
Absolutely,
yes,
anytime.
This is our first big showing, so.
Well, you guys always have a lot of cars out here.
Well, we were a little worried. We got some members out of town, but we've had a lot of new members join today, and I think we have about 22 or 23 cars. We actually had to squeeze one in right there. So
there you
we
go.
Love you.
Double-digit cars. We appreciate you guys for bringing all of them out and organizing everything.
Thank
so,
you. Yes,
thank you so much. I really do appreciate it.
Showing it. So, yeah, we've got some really cool cars. Everything from the very beginning years all the way up to the newest.
Yeah, literally every generation
every
of
generation
Miatas are
here.
So,
yes,
if people want to learn more, they can go to your website, MusicCityMiataClub.com.
Thank you so much. We have a lot of good events planned for this year. We have a lot of fun. So, thanks for coming by.
You're more than welcome. Have a great day.
Thank you.
Okay, so more custom cars, lots of Miatas. Miatas are one of the most popular beginning track cars because they are cheap and they are light and relatively easy to modify and make more power out of?
Why don't we pick a random... Let's take a left here.
We're going to... Okay, slow down here. So, stop here. Really is a lovely day here. Thank you all again for joining us on the AAA live stream. We've got literally everything out here today. We've shown you a lot of supercars. We've shown you some rare vehicles. John Hennessey spent a couple minutes with us on the stream. So that was awesome. Learned he was from Kansas City. Interesting fact, I was born in Kansas City. I am from the Show Me State. And right now I'm showing you a Dodge Demon. Look at that. I love, every time I see a Demon, I always look for this, and then I look for the thing on the tires, which is the special Demon-only tires, which is right there. You can see that. So there's a little bit of Demon knowledge if you didn't already know that. Check out that interior. Super, super no nonsense, very clean. Car just makes a ton of power. I don't know, it'd probably be a toss up between the dump truck and the Demon. But I'd take the Demon. And check out this Mustang. Let's see, it's a nice paint job. Somewhere between fuchsia and Mystic Chrome. In blue. Wait, what is this? Okay, so now it's brown over here. Wow, there's all sorts of cool colors in this car. And obviously this guy's operating on some sort of air ride suspension. Living the low life when deemed necessary. Richard Emerson, watching from New Zealand. Well, hello, my Kiwi friend. How are you doing today? Mystery colors? Yeah, it could be mystery colors. I mean, it's... I call everything Mystic Chrome, because that was the first thing I saw that idea on. But there's a lot of custom colors out there. Slow down, slow down. Oh, okay, so we got to look at the ZL1 right here. Check this out, guys. Woo, look at the color work that went into that. Beautiful blue all over the body, and then that yellow paint match to the wheels, the mirrors, the roof. Man, that is nice. All right, so that was cool. Almost like a blue angel. Okay, so I think I fielded everybody's request, more or less. That's ghastly. Well, hold on, we gotta see that. All right, we got like a Halloween thing going on here. How'd you like to be cruising down 65 and see that in your rear view? Better yet, how'd you like to see this out in the desert and it come up behind you? I think that's much scarier. Like 95 out in Nevada. Nobody around for miles. Area 51, not too far away. This comes up behind you. One headlight broken. Exhaust leak. This thing would sound, I don't know, man, it'd scare me. But very cool themed car. We got a lot of theme cars out here. And we got some brass knuckles right there as the oops handle. Okay, we've had a request for street rods. Brian Stanley, the Subaru count is massive. There's a lot of Subarus here. We seem to be in Cobra country at the moment, so grab your snake bite kit. And I just counted like 10 supercharged Mustangs in a row. So that's cool. Stop here for a second. So there's just a really well-kept FJ right here. That front winch, in case you have any problems on the trail. Maybe you overestimated your abilities. Maybe you underestimated your mechanical ability. But a nice get out of jail. Look at that, beautiful. Super, super meaty tires back here. Well, no, I've seen Meteor, but still, for the year, for the vintage, as they say. All right, where's next? Take us to the right. Theme cars, there's another theme car right there. That's the Jurassic Park theme car. Yeah, you can turn left. And then turn right. So continuing the theme of theme cars, we're gonna drive by the Jurassic Park car. A lot of attention to detail. And look at that. Got a Raptor hanging out the hood. Don't see that every day. Hi guys. All right, let's go straight into the right. Got some foci hanging out. Blue RS. Let's see here. So the lights on that Jeep are still going off. That's cool. Guys, bear with us for a second. We're gonna change locations more or less. So we talked to John Hennessey earlier. We've seen a grip of cool cars. Ooh, let's check this out. So some of you guys are saying that I'm not giving the classics enough love. Well, take a look at this. Saw this guy drive by a minute ago. Actually, I saw him drive up at the beginning of the show. Give this car 5 snooches up easily. Look at that. Man, it smells good. I love it when you can stand next to a car and you can smell the vintage in it. It's absolutely gorgeous. And one of the things I like is the rear view mirror down low. Look at that shifter. You got your cue ball right there. Your aircraft-like controls in the center console. Screams 50s. ZL1. It's a really nice day out today, guys. And like I said and keep saying, we're not done yet. If you live nearby, you can still come on down. We're at 633 Fraser Boulevard. A lot of lovely rides. And you know what? We never looked at the Ford GT, and I wanted to go look at that. Now, the new Ford GT is a turbo V6, and this one isn't. This is the supercharged 5.4.
You'll be telling
me what I'll do. Please!
And I like this one an awful lot. Just kind of want to watch the clouds float on by. And then, we can actually see inside. There's that canted shifter, about 20, 30 degrees to the left. Theoretically, to make it easier and faster to shift when you're being propelled by hundreds of foot-pounds of American torque. All right, so give me a like for that Ford GT. That Ford GT is pretty awesome. Awesome color, nice power plant, clean interior.
Hey, Andrew's here.
Where is
Andrew's here? We're parked in the back, in the corner.
Wait, come park way over there.
Yeah, so we're gonna come up right here. So you can stop right here. Excuse us. Whoa, look at this.
Daily driver, that's why.
Got a 1LE. Chuck, your guess is as good as mine. But this parking lot, you can't squeeze any more cars in here. It is not possible. So let's see what's over here. Hello. Hey, Sean, how are you?
I'm good. How are you?
I'm good, man. Thanks for coming out today.
For having us.
Now, what is it that you do?
I am a part owner of Veloci Auto Spa. We're the detail shop located at Veloci Auto Parts.
Okay, so you guys run a detail shop, and then you guys have a special for NCC guests going on right now, don't you?
Yep, we have the special coupon code for Cars and Coffee. Gets you 10% off of any service. It does not expire, so this is a coupon code to hold and use over and over. We also have a free detail giveaway where we're taking names and we run a raffle for a $250 detail, which consists of a car wash, clay bar decontamination, six-month sealant, and a glass coating, one-year glass coating.
Awesome. So we got multiple things. So we're giving away stuff, and we've got a discount code for NCC.
Correct.
Guests only. And they can redeem that through your website. What is your website?
It's www.velocityautospa.com.
And you guys are here in town locally. You've been doing it for over 20 years. You got a ton of experience, and you work with a lot of supercars, right?
Correct.
Yeah. Awesome.
Yep.
Well, you guys brought a couple cars out today, right?
Yep, we brought the Mercedes AMG GTR. We brought the Ferrari 488 Spider. We've got the Porsche GT3. And then we brought the 2008 Mercedes SL65 Black Series.
Wow, that's a lot of cars, man.
Yeah.
That's a lot of cars. Well, thank you so much for bringing them out. I appreciate it.
Thank you for having us.
And for sure, we'll see you next month.
Definitely. We'll see you there.
All right, guys, we're going to take a quick peek of this automotive awesomeness that was just described to us from Sean. And Velocity really does a lot of great work. Let's take a look at what we've got here. Chris, you spoiled the surprise. I was trying not to show the SL65, but you caught it. You win the Eagle Eye Award.
brakes on the planet. So, and then a lowly GT3 in what can only be described as canary yellow. Still a good-looking car. Look at that wing. If you need a lunch table, just hop up there and turn around. You can eat off that. That's just a joke, guys. It's just a joke. And then, yeah, the SL65. Oh, we get to see inside the GT3. Carbon fiber accents. Got your suede or suede-like cousin. Looks like we're rolling PDK in here. Very good. Very, very good. The clock's still moving.
Not much to see.
No, not much to see, but we know what's under there.
It makes great sounds.
It does make good sounds. Good at turning money into noise. So let's take a look at the SL65. Thank you, Josh. All right, so share if you like the GTR, the 488, the GT3, or the SL65. If either one of those floats your boat, hook us up with a share. We appreciate it. The more shares, the better. Okay, guys. Oh, so, man, I could do this for forever. I really could. BMW of Nashville was kind enough to bring out the new X7. So maybe you've been on this thing called Facebook lately, and maybe you've ever seen a meme in your life, but on a lot of the automotive Facebook pages, people are talking about these new grills. And these new grills are as every bit as big in person as they look in pictures. I'm a big guy, and I think if I pulled those grills off, I could climb in there if there was nothing on the other side. So, it's hard to put into words how big this is, other than it fills the entire frame, and we should be able to see a lot more than grills from this far away. But there's some hexagonal angel eyes now. So, I still want to kind of not do a deep dive on this car, but I do want to take a look at it. Take a look at some critical features right here. Boring. So what I want to do is see on the inside. So there's a lot of space here. We've got three rows. Now, guys, bear with me. I've never been inside an X7 before. I haven't seen one before today. I've seen pictures like you have. We've got the pano roof that the X5 has carried over. Carried over from the X5, I imagine. That's where we've all seen it before. Oh, look at that interior. You got a super wide, what I can only assume is a touchscreen navigation. And I'm gonna just go ahead and do it live because I know this is a dealer car and it's not a person's car. And look at that. Absolutely gorgeous. So it looks like this car is a M Sport model. You've got the M Sport, or the M logo on the steering wheel. And it smells good in here. Again, not that old classic vintage smell, but that new BMW hotness, if you like. So yeah, this thing absolutely looks amazing. We've got some giant wheels here in the back. Big fat tires. So it looks like this third row obviously folds down, gives you some semblance of storage. Check that out, X7. That's cool. I never thought I would see that in my life, but there it is. It's like you got some trunk controls there, got some auxiliary, more controls there. So BMW doing its thing, packing a lot of car into not a lot of space. And Steven, sometimes you just got to do it live, my friend. You know, it's better to beg for forgiveness than ask for permission. But don't do that with, you know, other regular people's cars. I only did that because that's a dealer car, and I know it's a dealer car. If you walk up to some stranger's car and jump in it,
They're probably going to be upset with you, and rightfully so. Rightfully so. Yeah, sorry, getting tongue-tied. So it is 9:40, and the sun is rising. Check out this GTR rolling by. Good looking Corvette there. Now guys, again, thank you for watching the AAA live stream from Nashville Cars and Coffee. We really appreciate them being part of the event and supporting the live stream. As you guys, if you've been watching the whole time, you can see that we've had people from New Zealand. We had someone else from, I'd have to go back and look, but it was on the other side of the planet. Was it somewhere in Europe? I don't know, I forget. But how about this? Sound off if you're from outside of the United States, if you're watching from outside of the United States. And I'll give that a few seconds and see how long it takes you guys to do that. But thank you for watching the AAA live stream today. If you guys live in Middle Tennessee and you're looking for car insurance, home insurance, pretty much any type of insurance, reach out to AAA Tennessee on their Facebook page. How you doing, man?
Hey, doing great. How are you?
I'm good, thank you. I'm Carson Coffee Dave.
Andrew, nice to meet you.
Andrew, I don't know if we've ever met before, man.
Yeah, so I'm the insurance manager for our Cool Springs office as well as our Murfreesboro one.
Mm-hmm.
So not only do we do the AAA membership where we help you off the side of the road, but we've got some really great rates for auto and home insurance. We just unveiled some new products in Tennessee here in October, and our members are saving a ton of money with us. So
that's awesome.
Yeah.
So if people have maybe not looked at their car or home insurance in the last 2 or 3 years, now's a great reminder to go do so. If you live in Middle Tennessee, specifically, you guys are all over Middle Tennessee for your coverage area?
Yeah, we've got 4 branches in Tennessee. So we've got one in Cool Springs, Murfreesboro, as well as Nashville and Hendersonville.
Mm-hmm.
And those products are for the entire state of Tennessee. So anywhere you are in the state, we can definitely help you out.
Awesome. Now, is there a specific website that they need to go to or Facebook page?
I would say just search it for your local branch. So in our areas, go to the AAA Cool Springs website. You can also give us a call at 615-376-1601, and we'll definitely take care of you.
Awesome. Well, thank you very much, Andrew.
Yeah, no problem.
I appreciate it.
Bye.
All right, guys. Well, you know what? It is a beautiful day. It is starting to get a little warm out here, and I've been going for over an hour, I believe. We've talked to John Hennessey. We've seen this amazing 6x6 Velociraptor. We've talked to some vendors. We've seen cool cars. We've seen classic cars. We've seen modified street cars. We've seen dogs. Last month, there was a plane here. We saw a big dump truck today. We saw all sorts of awesomeness, and we couldn't do it without you guys. Thank you so much for helping us cross 20,000 followers on our Facebook page. If you have a friend that you might think could get into cars, or a friend that is currently into cars, but maybe they don't follow the page, share our page, share our content. Let other automotive enthusiasts know that this event happens. It's amazing how many people we talk to here in Nashville that have heard of it, but they've never come to it. And then once they come to it, they're addicted to it, and they have to keep coming to it and just see everything that's out here. So thank you all very much for watching the AAA live stream. My name's Cars and Coffee Dave, and we will catch you next time. Have a great day. Bye-bye.